Right, folks, I'm on the north side of the gorge. No cows, not many people. There are people about on the different tracks. There's people over the other side, on the south side, walking about. And there's people walking on the little track that was just down there. And I've seen several places where you can climb over if you wanted to, but I'm just carrying on here. It's actually easier to walk. More room, more views. So there we go. Black rock over there. Ran over that way. Over there, the south side of Cheddar Gorge. In winter, all the trees are asleep. In autumn, there's a kaleidoscope of colour. Amber, yellow, green, brown. I can just about see Glastonbury Tor again. Only just. On this humpy, bumpy ground. Just see Glastonbury from here in the mist. I'll just zoom in. I saw it much earlier in the day when I was on the other side of the gorge. Can't see any little much people up there, but I expect there are. That's Glastonbury, not far away. Never far away. Down there we've got an island mound in the mist. Brent Knoll and the Cheddar and Axbridge Reservoir. Which I'm going to have a little walk round another day. Look at these lovely clouds all high up. It's supposed to be rainy tomorrow, so that's why I fitted this walk in today, really, because the weather is changing every minute and every day. You can never guarantee a sunny, blue sky, crisp day like this every day. No, you can't. Right through there in the distance, people who know now, Crook's Peak. It will be visited sometime this year. It will. A bit blowy up there in the winter, but I've done it. Yeah, so it's been quite a good day. Strenuous in places. And I can actually say at the moment, no wheezing. It's taken nearly the whole walk to get rid of the wheeze. And there we have the massive Cheddar Gorge, look. Hardly noticeable sometimes in the winter with all the dark wood asleep. Yeah, I can hear the quarry. Right, I'm just going to turn off to take some pictures of the reservoir and Glastonbury. Right, over and out. There's the gorge. Oh, right. Got a good hour and a half for the bus, so I thought I'd just do a little diversion walk. You can see somebody right on the top of the gorge over there, with a red top on. I've seen them. See? Where are they? Oh, there they are, yeah. I can hear something whizzing down the gorge. I'm not quite sure what it is. It might be a go-kart of some sort, because I think they're allowing go-karts. I'm not sure. Anyway, here we are. Look, all the trees asleep. Some look a bit black and whatever. I'm not going right down there. That takes you right down to the edge where the cliff edge is. I'm not doing that. I should keep up higher. Oh, I keep getting caught up in brambles all the time. There was a goat right on the wall a minute ago. He was just standing on the wall, wondering whether he should jump over or not, I suppose. Yeah, we might just go down there a bit and have a look, but I don't want to walk down that bit. It's a bit slippery. So we'll just go down here. I do this now and again, this bit. It's just because you have a different perspective of the gorge. We're on the north side, looking over to the south side. I'm going to be going along that trail there. We've got the sun in our face a bit. I've got a battery charger on now. I forgot to charge the batteries up as I was going along, so I'm having to hold the camera and the charger at the same time. But it's still a lovely day, folks. It's still a lovely day. We've got the sun in our face. But you can walk down to like a platform area down there to look over at the gorge if you want to see all the geology and that. They have pruned it back a bit. They've been doing a lot of work on the gorge, trying to make it safer and to protect it. Because I think some of the trees actually do damage the rocks and stuff. So some people do walk so close to the edge, it's scary really. So anyway, we're having this lovely walk. It's a lovely day. I've timed it quite well without leaving it too late. So we'll be getting the 20 past four. Well, 19 minutes past, but I always get there 10 minutes early in case the bus changes its mind. We'll be getting that one, which gets us back about half past five to Weston, which is okay as well. Look at that lovely view. It's gorgeous, isn't it? Gorgeous view. Let me just take a picture of it. Go back on. A young couple that had gone on have decided to come back here. And there's some goats there in front of me. They'll soon disappear. Soon disappear. Yeah, it's quite a nice little walk. So I don't think I've got to do anything steep. Yeah, look at those there, look. Him. Just going to turn off and take a picture. Hello, blue goaties. How are you doing? How are you doing then? Alright? Lovely tree that. See, there's a couple of goats on the wall there. They're so cheeky. Aren't you? Cheeky. Getting on the wall again. Eh? Oh, Billy Goat. You've got a lovely beard, haven't you? You've got a lovely beard. Look at you. My goodness, you're beautiful, love. You're beautiful. Right, so I'm at the gorge. I've just been talking to a load of goats. We've got different types. This one here is a really good billy goat gruff. with his wife, I think. They're beautiful. Look at the colour of them. He's been walking along the wall. Look, there he goes. He's overtaken there. Or he's saying, get a move on. He's beautiful. Look at him. He's beautiful. Aren't you? God, they're so gorgeous. I'm not going to go up to them. I don't want to frighten them. But I reckon I will be close to them in a minute because I've got to climb over the wall yet. Look at them. They're really, really beautiful, those two are. God, they are so special. If you know what I mean. They're paired up. That's husband and wife. Isn't it beautiful, though? Got their own distinctive colour. Fur. See which way to go. I think I've got to go down this way. Don't know if I can get along that top, but can you there? There might be a way. Oh, they've jumped. They've both jumped. They've gone into that thicket there. I missed that. I've timed the weather just right, really, because let me just see if they've where they've gone. Yeah, they're just going in to have some food in there. They managed to jump without getting caught on the new barbed wire. It's just getting a bit dark now. I think they sort of pair up for a little while because most of the time the rams stay together and the female goats, ewes, I think they're called, they stay together. And they sort of pair up. Of course they do, so they wouldn't have any little tiny ones, would they? It's getting a bit brambly for me along here. I don't know how you're going to get through this bit, but I suppose we will. I'm taping this because I don't do it that often. I don't do this at all in this. I keep away from the gorge a lot in this. I keep it at a distance. There's a lovely big goat in front of me, going to greet me as I go through the gap. Here's another one with a great big fur, great big beard. Look at the view I've got of the gorge. And I've noticed some of the goats, I mean, they're so precariously positioned on the gorge. You wonder how they can possibly not fall off. There's one, he's black and white, and I took a picture of him earlier. And he's right on the edge, and he's eating. He's not asleep or anything. He's right on the edge there, isn't it? Where is he? Because I'm having trouble with the camera, and everything's green, and it's hard to focus. And I'll zoom out again. I'm trying to get... there he is, there. There, see that goat there? How on earth did he get down there? And look at this one just coming into view. He's just passed me, he had a big long beard. He's looking for a mate. Look at him. Good place for seeing the goats, they've got lovely coats. He's on his own, what they've done, they're all on their own at the moment. Look at that, geology. But like I said, there's one down there eating grass on the edge, like a speck he is. And yeah, it's a beautiful evening, everyone. Really is beautiful. There's the crows, lots of crows about. bit of damaged wall here. I expect they'll have to be repaired. Yeah, there's a big goat there. He's looking for a mate. They try to find their own colour, you know. I mean, if you look at that male and female, they were grey and white, paired up. Look at that view, though, everyone. Look at it. How powerful that is. Fortunately, I know it's going to come out all right. It's just that when I'm looking through the viewfinder, it's all in kaleidoscope. Right over there, we've got Glastonbury. Let's just point it out again. Right over there. There is a green hill far away, without a city wall. I can't see it at all. I know it's there. It's the kaleidoscopic colour. And there we have the gorge. There we have Cheddar Gorge in all its glory. You don't want to trip here, do you? You get lots of people set up here and have picnics. There's always a lot of crows. Maybe they pick up dead squirrels and things that get run over, or do you know what I mean, that get knocked onto the road. There's so many crows here. But look at that, isn't that fantastic, that gorge? Fantastic, isn't it? Like I said, I don't know how that goat gets there. It's absolutely amazing, goats are. He's right on the edge. Yeah, they've done quite a bit of pruning. Quite a bit of pruning. If a big stone fall in there, they probably do have to sort of give it a little bit of a check for the falling stones. Yeah, this hour and a half has been giving me a chance to do this, actually, rather than bombing on down the gorge, try to get the 20 past three. My son used to be one of those boys that, boy racer. Yeah, look at that view though, everyone. Look at that bus coming round the corner, look. That coach. He only just got round there, didn't he? He only just got round there. God, isn't it gorgeous? I'm going to take some photographs. Everything's so gorgeous, I don't want to stop videoing, really. Yeah, over there we've got the... Everything's so gorgeous. I'll just do a bit more videoing, I think, for a minute. Just do a bit more videoing. Yeah, gorgeous. I'm glad I came this way now. Because I had time, I thought, yeah, come this way, Sheena. Gonna take some photos now. It's just so gorgeous, everyone. Over and out.